Dementia is a challenge for so many families here in Singapore, across the world. My mom is suffering from it, and we know many of our friends whose parents are suffering from it as well. Right here in Singapore, there is a real push to get the word out about dementia and some of the things that can be done to make life more comfortable, not only for those suffering from dementia, but also the caregivers who are helping their loved ones with it. Let's talk now to Munah Bagharib, Dementia Singapore Ambassador. Great to have you on, Munah. Thanks for being with us today. This is such an important issue that we are talking about today. How did you come to be a Dementia Singapore Ambassador?
I've always known about Dementia Singapore before, they were known as Dementia Singapore. But it only happened maybe about 5-6 years ago when my mom was first diagnosed with dementia. And at that point of time, and I don't know, I think it happens in my generation as well, where we're not very aware. I've always known about dementia, but I never know exactly what it entails. So when it was a lot closer to home, both me and my brother were just lost at, you know, where to go from here, what to do. Dementia Singapore was one of the places that we turned to because there were so many resources that we didn't know of. There were so many things to learn about, you know, how to take care of my mom, how to make it a little bit more comfortable, a little bit more happier for her. So when the opportunity came to be part of them, I jumped on it completely because I think they were such a big part of, you know, that journey experiencing how to manage dementia.
Yeah, Munah, your story will resonate with so many Singaporeans listening right now. I think myself, Glenn mentioned earlier, we all have someone affected with dementia. If you can, you know, I know it's a delicate issue, take us through the process that happened between you, your brother, and your mother, you know, the early stages, the early signs, what happened, and then what your journey was with your mother.
She started forgetting, or like, you know, like calling me by another name or just calling something else. And to us, it was just part of it. I mean, like, we forget all the time too, you know, like we call it people by the wrong names, and it's just very simple mistakes that we didn't think were red flags. But there was a point of time where it got more obvious or significant. Like she would call something that she would very much know what the name is, something completely different, and we were just like, hey, something's not clicking here. And we thought, okay, you know what, why not just go for a checkup? Like, there's no harm in that, right? And so when we did, it was quite overwhelming, because I think, and I say this a lot to people, like, you always know about it, but you don't think that it would happen to you or that it would happen so close to you. And when it does, it's just the whole world shifts and you're like, okay, how do I navigate through this now? So it was quite an overwhelming time finding out about the diagnosis and just, you know, not knowing so much about dementia and knowing such, like, it came with so many negative connotations. But at the same time, I think learning about it and going through it over the past few years, I think it's not always that, you know, it is something that someone goes through, but it doesn't have to be something that you focus on when it's bad, you know, there's some good that comes out from it too. So I think over the years we've learned how to help her. Like, that's the main focus, at least for my family, is just to keep her happy, because you can see when she was first diagnosed, like, she was insecure about it, she wasn't sure what she was going through, and every time, like, she made a mistake about, you know, like, what was happening, or she was confused, and we tried to correct her, like, even more she would feel anxious. So I don't know if you go through this as well with the people around you who have dementia, where, you know, they get confused and you're like, okay, how do I help the situation? So the focus for us was really to just make it, like, as easy for her
You empathize with that with your mother.
Yeah. We're talking with Munah Bagharib, the Dementia Singapore Ambassador, actress and influencer. Munah, a couple of kind of multi-part question here. First of all, what was the most surprising thing that you learned about dementia in dealing with your mom's journey? And what is maybe one thing that you learned as a caregiver or as a loved one that you could or should do to ease their situation?
I think the one thing I picked up from dementia is that there are so many layers going through it. Because so when I, for example, like when I first spoke to my friends about, you know, my mom having this diagnosis, they were like, oh, okay, she's going to forget you. Has she forgotten you yet? And this is like just a few months in. And I'm like, no, I think it's a longer process than that. And I think that's the misconception that people have about dementia, that, you know, it's just immediately forgetting. But there's so much that they go through. And that's why I say, like, people think like it's scary, but it's not scary. It's really just something that you go through, and it doesn't always have to be a bad thing. What I picked out as a caregiver is really the focus is on her. Like, there's no point. I was very affected by it. I won't lie, that I think my whole family was very affected by it. But there's no point in focusing on like, oh my God, what's happening now? You know, like, I think, like, I watched her and I saw how confused she was, and I know I needed to step up to make her feel like it's okay, that we're all always there. So I think support is very important as well.
And Munah, how has your communication changed with your mother? And maybe what communication tips would you give to others listening out there who may have relatives in their family or, like yourself, are a caregiver?
I would say, how do I say this? I think sometimes you don't have to always correct them or try to talk like logic, you know what I mean? So there are times when, and I spoke to my mom's doctor about this, because, you know, as the dementia, like, it's been a few years already, so things change. And I spoke to the doctor about, like, how do I communicate with her so that, you know, it's not confusing all the time. And she was like, you know what, if she says something is this, or if she believes that she's in this time, just roll with it. There's no point, you know, trying to correct them, because then it just makes them a lot more anxious. And I think you just have to be very, very calm, very patient, you know, always keep your cool, because that's really important.
Yeah. What are the resources that that Dementia Singapore has? And I've put the link for their helpline and also for their website in our MoneyFM chat on Facebook. And please feel free to add any other links that you would like to in that space. Oh, okay. But what does Dementia Singapore actually do in terms of helping folks?
I mean, the main thing is, of course, like, to spread awareness about dementia. But at the same time, I think it helps a lot of, you know, families or people who are going through it. From my own experience, like, I turned to them to understand a lot more about what dementia was, and mainly for resources in terms of, like, where to go, because there are all these centers that help. So one of the places that we got in touch with was this place called Brahm Center. So they kind of have people who, like, caregivers, for example, or we get to learn how to deal with it, how to make things better. And as caregivers also, we have like a little support group, so that really helps. And that's where I tend to. So there are all these resources where, you know that there's a community there and you don't feel so lost.
Alone. Munah, as you work with your mother and you go out into public spaces, what have you encountered or noticed in the way that others, you know, maybe react to your mother or react to people with dementia? And what advice or tips would you give those who may not have anyone suffering from dementia in their family, but could help to make it easier as a community, as a society, for those that do?
Like I said, I think with you know, a person with dementia, you can't always tell. Like, if you saw my mother, you wouldn't be able to, like, pick it out immediately until maybe when you speak to her. And then sometimes she gets confused at, like, what people are saying, and I would come in to speak to her. So my advice is to just, like I said, like, be calm, stay understanding, because it's not obvious, but, you know, you just, if you see any signs of, like, confusion or anxiety in anyone at all, just just try to explain it to them in a more patient, a more calm approach. I think that's most important, because if you confuse anyone even more, like you just get a lot more confused, and then you won't get your point across. So
yeah. Munah, you know, one of the challenges that myself and my brothers think about is, okay, yeah, our mom has dementia. Are we going to get it? You know, are we candidates for it? And there are various genetic tests you can do. But also the other part of this is that there are now increasing numbers of drug treatments that you can do, not to reverse dementia, but to delay its major onset. Mm-hmm. What have you learned about those two areas when in your research working for Dementia Singapore?
There are those I suppose resources, and people have talked to me about, like, okay, you can take this to help it. I think it's still, at least for me, it's still something that I'm learning, and I haven't mm-hmm. quite gotten into any of it. Have you, actually? I'm interested now.
I don't know enough to talk intelligently about it. I know a little bit, but just enough to be dangerous.
Yeah, same to me. I think, like, I don't know enough to make an educated decision on it yet, but I know there are these there are these things that you can turn to, and yeah, it's definitely one of the things my family and I think about. But for now, what we do is just to still keep our mind active, do whatever we can now. But I feel like at least now we're a bit more aware of what might come. So that's the stage that we're at the moment.
Well, final question from me, Munah. Looking ahead, based on your experiences now with your mother, what do you think we need to ensure that Singapore becomes a truly dementia-inclusive society?
I think to me it's as simple as a shift in words, I think, especially for the new generation. All of us like now everyone's talking about it, like there is awareness of it for sure. And I think, like, really the way you speak about it, the kind of words you use to describe dementia makes a big difference, you know, like it's not always such a bad thing. I think it's more about understanding and being there for a person with dementia rather than, you know, having this kind of opinion on what it is. Yeah.
I'd like to think that Munah's putting us all in the same generation when she when she said that, I thought, we are at least 20 years older than you, Munah. At least.
And maybe 30. Okay, but anyway, that's okay. I'll take the same generation, Munah. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
In fact, I may even slip you a little bit of money for having done that. I appreciate that.
Our same generation, us and Munah.
We are all in the same generation.
Those young kids.
Hey, Munah, thanks for being with us today and talking to us about Dementia Singapore. Dementia.org.sg is the website. Munah, there are some questions and comments on our Facebook Live page. If you wouldn't mind maybe hanging back and throwing in a few comments about your experience, and that we'd really appreciate that. In the meantime, thank you for being with us. We hope to have you on again in the future to talk more about this really, really important topic for so many families. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.